Hidden amongst the new features of Studio One Pro 7 were a few updates for those of you who use MIDI. You need to know about these, so let's dive in. This video is sponsored by DistroKid. Follow the VIP link in the description down below to get 7% off an already amazing price to distribute your music to the world. This first feature is not strictly speaking a MIDI feature. However, if you use MIDI a lot, then you probably should know about it. Let's take a look at this MIDI event over here, which is actually a pattern. If I double click on it, you'll see it appear in the pattern editor down below. Now, one of the great things about patterns is they're really easy to loop. You simply grab the right-hand side of the event and drag it out to the point you want to loop it to. However, in previous versions, the same could not be said of parts created in the piano roll view, such as these strings here. If you simply grab the right-hand side of this event and drag it out, you're creating blank space. You're not looping anything at all. So in previous versions, the workaround for this was simply to highlight the event and then hit D on the keyboard to duplicate it. Now, this is a duplicate. It's not a true loop. If, for example, we were to go to the first event here and drag this green note around, it moves in that event, but it doesn't happen in the other event, so it's not a true loop. Well, in Studio One Pro 7, we have some new features to deal with this. You simply go to the bottom right-hand corner of the event and then just drag it out in the same way as you did previously with patterns, and you're creating a loop. And it's a true loop, because if I go ahead again and adjust that note, when I release, you can see that change is applied to all of the loops. Super handy. Now, this is not the only way that you can loop events in Studio One Pro 7. Let's take a look up here at this track, which is an 808 bass. At the beginning, I've got an event here. I want to loop it here up until this event over here, which is a variation. Well, what you can do is right click on the event and then just click on loop like so. And it's going to loop until it reaches another event and then it's going to stop. If there isn't another event there, then it will simply loop until it finds the end marker in your project. Now, at the beginning, I said this is not strictly speaking a MIDI feature. And the reason I said that is these loop features can be applied to audio as well. Let's take this bass part I have up here. Again, I can just drag it out from the bottom right-hand corner and I can loop it like so. Or again, I can right-click on it and then just click where it says loop here. New to Studio One Pro 7 is the scale panel, and we open it by clicking on this little icon over here. Now, not all of the features here are new features. Some of them have just been moved and they used to be over on the left hand side. Now, one of those is the ability to set our scale. Now, my piece is actually in B minor, but I've set it to D major because, as the musical theorists will know amongst you, those keys are relative. They share the same notes, okay? Now, the other thing that we could do in the previous section, which we can do here as well, is click on Snap to Scale. And this just ensures that as we drag our notes around, that they're only landing on notes within the scale, like so. Now, something new to this version is the pitch visibility options. Over here, it's currently set to all, meaning we can see all of the pitches. However, we can set it to just in scale. So we're only seeing the notes from within the scale itself, and it can just keep things a bit more simple to look at. The other thing we can do is only see notes which have previously been used. So if you just want to stick to just a few notes from within your scale, then this may be useful to you as well. Now, I think that there is a problem that many of you see with using features such as only seeing or snapping to the notes from within the scale. And that's the fact that often we have the odd note here and there, which is not in the scale. Well, this next feature kind of deals with that. Have a quick listen to the pizzicato strings at the beginning of my piece here. Now, there's a couple of places where the chords dropped down momentarily and went back up. The first one is here, and the second one is here. And at the moment, all of the notes there are behaving nicely in the sense that they're remaining within the key of D major, which I set up here earlier. So, for example, this note here, if I wanted to move it up to the B flat here, I can't, yeah? Because that's not in the key of D major. Now, the fact is, I do want to move it up to B flat because I think it would be really nice if it just dropped down chromatically and went back up again. So what I have to do in this case is turn off snap to scale, then adjust that note like so, and then turn on snap to scale again if I want to make use of that feature. That's a little bit cumbersome if you have to do it often throughout the course of a whole piece. So what I would suggest you do in this situation is make use of a new feature, which is the custom scale feature. Now, to include notes which are not normally in the scale, all we have to do is go over to this keyboard over here and click on any of those notes to include them, or click on them again to exclude them. Okay, so I'm going to include the B flat here, which means now, even though I've got snap to scale switched on, I can now drag that note up to the B flat, like so. Now, if I want to make sure I do the same chromatic movement over here in this little chord progression here, then again, I can just drag this note up to B flat. Let's have a listen to the new progression. I like that. Now, if I want, I can actually save that or store it as my own custom scale for future use. Just a quick reminder that if you're releasing your music to places like Spotify, Amazon, Google Play, etc., follow the VIP link in the description down below to our sponsor, DistroKid, where you'll get 7% off of your first year of membership. In previous versions of Studio One, if you were using patterns and using the drum view, then with each note in the pattern, you could set up a different length and a different resolution. But this feature wasn't available if you were using the piano view when you were using patterns. But you can see here now in Studio One Pro 7, they've made this feature available. You can see here with these lower notes in my piano view that I've set them up with 16 steps at a resolution of 1/16. But further up here, if you look at these two notes, they're only 3 steps long with a resolution of 1/8 dotted notes. And then up here, this one is also 1/8 dotted notes, but it has 6 steps. So they all kind of get out of sync with each other when we start to loop this pattern. Let's have a listen. And in context with the piece of music, so even though we've used the loop feature to loop that pattern, we're actually getting a variation as we move on because we've got a different number of steps and a different resolution. I reckon that's rather cool. To be quite honest with you, Studio One Pro already satisfies my personal MIDI needs, but some of you are power users. So I'd be interested to know in the comments down below which MIDI features you'd like to see in future versions. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm Mike, I hope you're well, and I'll see you in the next video.